Hello students, myself Professor Ankur. I welcome everyone for the gate theory session in analog circuits. Today we are going to cover an important topic, MOSFET biasing, from the topic of MOSFETs. This is the second part of our MOSFET. Let's start with MOSFET biasing. So the first thing we are trying to discuss here is a fixed bias DMOSFET circuitry. So if you can see the figure carefully, you can see the DMOSFET biased to a negative voltage by the battery VGG, input resistance for the gate terminal RG, resistance RD for the drain terminal, the VDD battery, the two coupling capacitors C1 and C2 with input VI and output VO. So this is basically an amplifier circuitry which is using the fixed bias arrangement of the DMOSFET. So when you look at the center section, when you talk about the capacitors open during the DC equivalent circuitry, you will find the device with the two resistances and the two batteries. So when I go for the equation VGS, it will be equal to minus of VGG. I'm going to use the equation ID is equal to IDSS, 1 minus VGS by V peak the whole square. Whenever a sum will be given, you will be given all the values like VDD, VGG, RD, RG, and the device parameters. So when I use this logic and I solve the equation for drain current, ID is equal to IDSS, 1 minus VGS by V peak the whole square, you will get the value of ID. Now, when I go for KVL to the output loop, you will get the value of VDS as VDD minus IDRD. So this is how you calculate the operating point of the device, ID and VDS, for the fixed bias DMOSFET circuitry. The next arrangement is basically a self-bias arrangement in DMOSFET, where if you observe carefully at the input side, you will find a resistance of 1 mega ohm, that is our RG resistance, but we will not find the VGG battery, it will be absent. But you will find one member added in the circuitry, that will be the resistance at the source end, that is going to be your RS resistance. So it is as good as we are trying to bias the DMOSFET with the help of the RS resistance. And that's the reason this circuitry is defined as self-bias arrangement. So now when I go for the KVL to the input loop and I try to get the value of VGS, the value of VGS will be minus of IDRS. And when you use the equation ID is equal to IDSS, 1 minus VGS by V peak the whole square, and substituting in the equation, VGS is equal to minus of IDRS. On solving, you will get two values of ID. Out of that, one value of ID will be applicable to the circuitry and the other one will not be applicable to the circuitry. So when we take that value, normally we take the lower value of the two, whatever you obtain from the equation. That value of ID will be corresponding to the circuitry drain current, and then we can go for KVL to the output loop, where we go for VDS is equal to VDD minus of ID into RD plus RS. Automatically you will get the value of VDS. The most important aspect of the device, DMOSFET or EMOSFET, either of the cases, whatever is the drain current, same is going to be the source current. This feature was also seen in the devices like FET. The next arrangement for DMOSFET is a potential divider bias. The methodology of solving remains the same, or you can say similar to what we have used in the BJT circuits. The first thing is the input section will get replaced by the Thevenin circuitry. So we find a Thevenin's voltage as VDD into R2 divided by R1 plus R2, where the value of R1 here is 110 mega ohm and R2 is 10 mega ohm, and then the equivalent resistance RG will be R1 parallel R2. So when I go for replacing the input section by the Thevenin circuitry and then applying KVL to the input loop, you will get the value of VGS as VG minus IDRS. Again, we use the standard equation VGS as VG minus IDRS in the equation of drain current, where the equation of drain current was ID equal to IDSS, 1 minus VGS by V peak the whole square. So in the place of VGS, we have to substitute VG minus IDRS. So when you solve the equation, again you will land up with two values of ID, out of which the lower value will be applicable to our circuitry, and then that will be the corresponding value of drain current. You apply KVL to the output loop, we have VDS is equal to VDD minus IDRD minus IDRS. So it is as good as you can get the value of VDS as VDD minus of ID into RD plus RS. So solving this, you will get the value of VDS. So this is how you get the value of drain current and the VDS voltage for the DMOSFET potential divider bias circuitry. So here we are actually trying to accumulate few circuits of depletion type and enhancement type together. If you see the center section, you can see the depletion type. If you can see the center section, you can see the enhancement type feedback configuration, where you have using a E-MOSFET along with RG resistance connected between the gate and the drain point. So we have the VDD, we have the RD, and the RG resistance will work like a feedback element between the drain and the gate point. So automatically, when I go for the DC calculation, you will go for VGS is equal to VDS, and you will use the equation ID is equal to K bracket VGS minus VT the whole square, where K is half W by L mu C aux. So when you solve this, you will get the value of ID, and using that ID, you will get the value of VDS, which is VDD minus IDRD. And since here VDS is same as VGS, you can take VGS value as VDD minus IDRD. So this is the way you are going to go for the feedback configuration of E-MOSFET. When I go for the potential divider bias, the logic is also similar to your depletion type MOSFET, where the input section will get replaced by Thevenin. We'll end up at the same equation of VGS and VDS, but the only way difference is we are going to use a different equation for drain current. In depletion type MOSFET, the equation that we used was ID is equal to IDSS, 1 minus VGS by Vpeak the whole square. Whereas in E-MOSFET, the equation that we are using is ID is equal to half W by L mu C aux VGS minus VT the whole square. So as I was discussing the feedback bias in the MOSFET, so you can see the feedback bias arrangement, where you will find VGS is equal to VDS because there is no current flowing in RG resistance. It is all because of the E-MOSFET is having gate insulation, and that's the reason the current going inside the gate terminal will be as good as zero. So we have to use the equation of E-MOSFET to get the value of ID, and then when you apply cable to the output loop, you will get VDS is equal to VDD minus IDRD. So the important parameters for E-MOSFET is the threshold voltage VTH or VT and the conduction parameter KN. So this is just a small example regarding how do we solve a sum. So suppose we have a question given with a battery of 10 volt. So there are two resistances R1 and R2, each of 10 mega ohm. RD is 6 kilo ohm and RS is 6 kilo ohm. And suppose the parameter KN dash W by L is given as 1 milliampere per volt square, and the value of VT is 1 volt. So the term KM dash is actually corresponding to mu into C aux. So how do we solve this sum? Simple method. We first find the Thevenin's voltage VG, which is going to be VDD into RG2 divided by RG1 plus RG2. Since RG1 and RG2 are actually same, the voltage will be half of the battery voltage. That will be 5 volt. The value of VGS will be VG minus IDRS. So the value of VG is 5 volt, and hence VGS is 5 minus 6 times ID. When I use the equation ID is equal to half KN dash W by L VGS minus VT the whole square, I substitute the value of VGS as 5 minus 6 times ID, and solving this, I'll get ID value as 0.5 milliampere. Automatically, the value of VS is ID into RS, which will come as 3 volt, and VGS is basically VG minus VS, so you're getting VGS as 2 volt. The value of the node terminal voltage VD is going to be VDD minus IDRD. So VDD is 10 volt, RD is 6K, current is 0.5 milliampere. So it will be 10 minus 6 into 0.5, landing up at 7 volts.